normal forms. So today I discuss about context free grammar. So CFG stands for context free grammar. It is a formal grammar which is used to generate all possible string or pattern of string in a given formal language. And in formal language theory, context free grammar is a formal grammar in which production rule is of form where V produce W, where V is a normal non-terminal symbol and W is a string consists terminals and non-terminals. Next. So context free grammar G be defined by four tuples. So G equal to V T P S. G is grammar which is consist of set of production rules. It is used to generate the string of a language. And T is the finite set of terminal symbol. It is denoted by lowercase letter. And V is the final set of non-terminal symbol. It is denoted by capital letters. And P is set of production rule which is used for replacing non-terminal symbol on left side of production in a string with other terminal of non-terminal symbol on right side of production. And S is the start symbol used to be derived the string. So next, here we can see a example. So let a language L equal to WC and WR, and W belongs to AB closure. Here W is a string and WR is a reverse string of W and C is a constant. So if we write W equal to AB, the WR will be BA, or W equal to ABB, then WR will be BBA. So the grammar could be start with S produce ASA, S produce BSB and S produce C. Now we check from the alphabet and string ABBCBBA. So first start with the start symbol. So A produce ASA. Now we go to the string and check the alphabet. So we place of S, we put BSB. Then we check again and then we put BSB. Now we get our result. Now Chomsky normal form. What is Chomsky normal form? So CNF stand for Chomsky normal form. CFG is in CNF if all production rules satisfy one of the following condition. And what are the following condition? Start symbol generating epsilon and equation will be A produce epsilon and A non-terminal generating two non-terminals where equation will be S produce AB or DC and A non-terminal generating a terminal where S produce A. And here we can see A, B, C are non-terminal symbol and alpha will be terminal symbol.
So now we will see an algorithm on how to convert context-free grammar into Chomsky normal form. So these are the steps to do so. So for the first step, we will see if our starting symbol, which is generally denoted by S, is occurring on the right hand side. If so, we will define a new production rule, S dash giving S. And for the next two steps would be to remove all the null and unit productions. For the fourth step, we will check if there are any productions having more than two symbols in the right hand side and we will try to replace them. And the fifth step would be to check if there is any production which is in the form A giving small a b and we will also try to replace that. So here we have an example and we will see how to solve this with the help of the discussed algorithm. So the problem says to convert CFG into CNF and the question is S giving ASA or small a b and a giving b or s and b giving small b or epsilon. So for the solution, the first step is we will check if s is appearing in the right hand side and we see that it is so we will introduce a new production rule s not producing s. Then for the second step, we will remove all the null productions. We can see that B is producing epsilon and in turn A is also producing epsilon. So first we will remove B producing epsilon and after removing so we get this new production set. And then we will see that A is also giving epsilon, which we need to remove. So after removing that, this is our new production set. The next step would be to remove all the unit productions. Now the unit productions here are S giving S, S not giving S, and A giving B. Also A giving S. So for S giving S, we will simply ignore that and write the production rule again without that S. And after removing S not producing, after removing S not producing S, the production set will become S not giving ASA or small a B or A or AS or SA. And then everything is as it is. And then we will try to remove A producing B by substituting the value of B, which is giving small b. And after that, we will try to remove A producing S by substituting the value of S. Next, we will find out all those which have two variables in the right hand side. We can see S naught is giving ASA and S is giving ASA. A is also giving ASA. So we'll try to remove this. And for removing this, we will simply substitute the value of ASA with X, that is X is producing SA, and we will substitute it in all those places where SA is there. And after that, the final step would be to check for all this production rules having the form A giving small a B, that is a terminal symbol followed by a non-terminal symbol. And we'll simply create another production rule, suppose Y giving A, and then we will replace all those things where the small a is there, and our final answer would be this. So now we'll see what is Grayback normal form. So it is a representation of context-free grammar which is in the form of the production rule capital A giving alpha X, where A is a non-terminal symbol, alpha is a terminal symbol, and X is a sequence of non-terminal symbols. That means it can be an empty string, or it can be one string, or it can be more.
Now I am going to discuss the steps to convert a context-free grammar to Grayback normal form. There are mainly five steps that we can follow to convert a context-free grammar to Grayback normal form. Step 1. At first, we have to check whether there is any such production where the start symbol S occurs in the right-hand side. If yes, then we have to create a new start symbol called S prime or any other variable's name we can give, which produce S, our previous start symbol. Then in step 2, we have to check if there are any null production present or not. If so, then we have to remove those production by using null production removing algorithm. And similarly, if there is any unique production, then we have to remove those by using removing unique production algorithm. Now in step 4, we have to remove all the left recursion, and then in the last step, we have to check all the production are in Grayback normal form or not. If any of those is not in Grayback normal form, then we have to do proper substitution of production to convert it into Grayback normal form. Okay, now let's see an example. Here is an example. We can see in the problem statement the production rules of the context-free grammar is given, and it says that S produce X, B or A produce small a or S A, B produce small b and X produce small a. We can clearly see that it is in Chomsky's normal form, so and there is no left recursion, so we can skip the first four steps of the algorithm and we can directly jump into the step 5. So now we have to do the needful substitution as the products all the production are not in Grayback normal form. So here we can see A produce SA and S produce XB or AA. These three are not in Grayback normal form. So we have to replace those production. So at first we will replace A produce SA production by substituting S produce XB or AA. And then we get the result. S produce XB or A produce small a or XBA or AAA, and B produce small b and X produce small a. Then in our latest production rules, we can see that X produce XB and B produce XBA. These are not in Grebeck normal form, so we have to replace those production. We will replace those production by substituting X produce small a, and we get the result here. We can see in the screen. And now we can say here A produce AAA. This is a left recursion, so we have to remove this. And by removing this left recursion, we get the result here. And then now in our previous, if we go back to our previous slide, and in our latest production, we can see C produce epsilon. It is a null production, so in Grebeck normal form there can't be any null production, so we have to remove it. So we will remove this production and we will get the result. You can see here. And then the production rules, S produce A, this is also not in Grebeck normal form, so we have to substitute it by with A produce small a C or small a B a C or small a B a, and then we get this result. Here we can also see that C produce AAA, this is not in Grebeck normal form, so we have to replace this production. So let's see how we can replace this production. So by replacing this production, we get the result. And here we can see this, our all the production rules are in Grebeck normal form. So this is the final result, and this is the equivalence Grebeck normal form of the given context free grammar. Okay, now we have came up to the conclusion part. And in conclusion, we can say there may be multiple Chomsky's normal form and Grebeck normal form of a particular context-free grammar. Chomsky's normal form and Grebeck normal form both produce the same language as generated by the context-free grammar, generated by the particular context-free grammar. Chomsky's normal form is used as a preprocessing steps for many algorithms like bottom up expressors CYK, and for generating a string of length n, we requires 2n minus 1 number of steps in Chomsky's normal form. And any context free grammar that do not have epsilon or do not contains epsilon is equivalent to Chomsky's normal form. Let G is a context free grammar, generate the language L equals to 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, n greater than equals to 1, and w equals to 000111 is a string from L. W is derived from the grammar G. If G is converted into Grebeck normal form, then the number of steps required to generate w equals to 000111 using Grebeck normal form of the context free grammar. The answer is 6. How? Here is the explanation. At first, here we can see S produce ASB or AB. This is the context-free grammar of the given language L. And in Grebeck normal form, it is S produce ASB or AB and B produce B. And this is the this is the substitution we have done here. and we here we can easily see that we required 6 steps. So the answer is 6. And now we'll go to the next.
So the second question we see, which of the following does not have left recursions? Chomsky normal form, Grebeck normal form, Backus normal form. So we know that Grebeck normal form is in the form A producing small a b, that is a terminal symbol followed by non-terminal symbol. So we can easily say that there is no tendency to have the left recursion. So the answer would be option B. And here we can see the explanation. Now the third question is, given grammar B, S producing AS, S producing AS, A producing SA, and A producing small a small b. So which of the following predictions denies the format of Chomsky normal form?
So this is the question number 2. Which of the following does not have left recursion? Chomsky's normal form, Grebeck normal form, Backus null form, all of them. The answer is B, Grebeck normal form. Why? Here is the explanation. You can see that the normal form format of Grebeck normal form is A produce small a b or A produce small a. This is a terminal symbol, so there can't be an left recursion. This is the question number 3. Given grammar G, S produce AS, S produce AAS, A produce SA, A produce small AA. Which of the following production denies the format of Chomsky's normal form? The answer is A. That's mean the production number 2 and 4. Why? There is the explanation. Actually, we have previously seen that in Chomsky's normal form, the production should be a terminal, two non-terminal symbol or a terminal symbol. But in second production here, S produced 3 non-terminal symbol, and in production number 4, A produce 2 terminal symbol, which can't be, which is not in Chomsky's normal form. And in question number 4, with reference to the process of conversion of a context-free grammar to Chomsky's normal form, the number of variables to be introduced for the terminals, the grammar is S produced ABA, A produced AAB, B produced AC. The answer is 3, and that is the explanation. Thank you, sir.
Very good presentation by Kuntal, Aditi, and Devanjana. Very good.